We're at New Fira Stadium in Snuffalo, home of the thrills.
Ah, it sure does get cold here in Snuffalo. Did you know that when the MFL first started, its very first season, a Snuffalo player suffered a hindquarters ass capitation? Yeah, it was 7 when it was tackled and it froze before it hit the ground.
And thus the saying was born, to freeze one own ass up. Let's play some football. Both teams hit the field ready to hit each other in this MFL matchup. The Purple Mutant Eaters go up against the Snuffalo Thrills. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. And MFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow and my partner Brickhead Mulligan and Mini Bricks. Heard you got a little touch of the mutant bird and pig flu. How you feeling, partner?
Well, the projectile vomiting finally let up, but the monsoon mudslides have begun. If you know what I mean.
I've been literally crapping his brains out all night. He's getting stupider by the hour, if that's even possible.
And it's 1st and 10. What a mess!
Tell me about it. It looked like Humpty Dumpty, the little Dumpty Dumpty in his pants when he got hit. Eh, can't blame him.
And it's 1st and 10. That's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. Second and 3. And he gets 3 yards on that run. Third down and a pussy hair.
Yo, seriously, man, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? I will wreck your world. You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world.
The offense is lining up to go for it on 4th down, and the defense is looking for a stop or a death. Either will work, but they prefer the kill. And the quarterback calls a sonic blast dirty trick and throws a supersonic missile to his receiver. 1st down! Defense was thinking run all the way. What a great call! And it's 1st and 10. Somehow and hold on for the 1st down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the 3rd set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. 2nd down and 7. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it too. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. Perfect pass and a score!
All it ever is aliens, aliens, aliens. They took our jobs, they took our women, and now they're taking our excessive celebrations.
Well, you can try to deport them if you want to, 27,000 children. Okay, nice and easy like a two-foot putt.
You miss two-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just guineas.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
The four people on the planet who care about rules and kickoffs must be happy to see a flag down.
I'm just happy to see anything after that laser pointer accident.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. They're going to be able to return this one. First and 10.
First down! I see this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
Good run for 5 yards.
Didn't love the changes, Gordon, did it? How good can it be?
Second down and 5. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and 10. Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown. And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Bricks. They're back up here on first down. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down and forever. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. He might have managed to dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, well, you know, mostly coffee. Tastes better, like Eskimos burying salmon heads, kimchi. I mean, anything really tastes good.
And that's the way you do it. Eat up chunks of yards with pinpoint passing. There's no reason to go for it here, but they do anyway. And the defense puts one over. And the defense anticipated a pass there and put an end to it. These guys need to talk to the ref about those calls. And by talk, I mean stomp him into the ground. It's not short, but it's a jailbreak. And the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Oh, crowd's loving it. First down and 5. yards on that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and two. And he rumbles into the end zone for the score.
I hope he's not going to dance now.
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
And so at the end of one, we're all tied up. We'll be right back. And it's first and ten. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. It's first and ten. And the running game is starting to click now. A pickup of eight on the play. Second down and two. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. First and ten. Well, that was a good throw.
Yeah, if he was aiming for the ground.
The ref that just called that penalty, he was convicted of marrying old ladies and stealing their savings.
That sounds like a good job.
He's right at home here taking money from coaches, players, and fans.
I even saw him swiping money from the bathroom attendant.
Yeah, who don't do that?
First down and seven. It in for the touchdown.
Yo, man, nobody can touch you an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. It's first and ten. Oh, look at this guy break tackles. He takes a licking and keeps on ticking. And that catch will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
Oh, I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest, I tell you.
And it's first and ten.
Paper, I scared on Shiva. I don't hear what I'll sell him.
Second down and more than the QB would like. blocking this guy. Ho-ho. And Bricks, they just made up a whole lot of field in a hurry with that pass play.
And I just made up a new name for a sandwich.
Ballsy? Stupid, maybe? I guess we'll decide after we see how this goes. But probably stupid. Roid Rage ignites that deep down violent rage and makes you unstoppable. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown!
Say what? Come on, man. You can't hang with me. You get my grill, I'm gonna ruin your world. You understand me?
And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
It's first and 10. That pass play nets them 7 yards.
Oh, no. I got the hiccups again. What are you supposed to do to get rid of them again?
You stick your head in a plastic bag, say the alphabet backwards while you set yourself on fire, and jump out the window. It ought to stop.
Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my off season.
And it's first and 10. Nice pickup for 6 yards. And that'll be second down and 4. There aren't too many players that kids can look up to at home. I'm glad one guy is stepping up. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out.
And we're at the 2-minute warning, folks. Stay tuned for the halftime show. And it's first and 10. They stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with 2 in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
Defense gives up 5 yards there. They stop the clock, but they only have 1 timeout left.
That's okay, Grim. They can have 9.
That's nice, Bricks. But our timeouts are for our sponsors, and we need money more than they do. Well, that play didn't work. They'll have to rethink that. Smart move there as they call a timeout, trying to get the ball back for another shot. Most kickers should be able to make this one.
But will this kicker make it? Find out next time on MFL Game Day.
MFL isn't... Well, surprise me. He made it look easy and he gets 3 points for it. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. Sack there. I heard this guy likes to play with soft balls. He's gonna play with crushed balls from here on out.
Hey, man, I was hitting on the pedal now. You know what I have?
Second down in a mile. Pull that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
And that's a great 9-yard completion there.
Hey, it ain't great if you don't score or move the chains.
And defense burns its last timeout. You can't take them into the locker room, so you might as well use them now.
Why would you want to take a timeout into the locker room, Grim? That doesn't sound right.
And he booted a high arcing rainbow. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. It's a close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsatan Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. Third quarter about to begin here, and these guys are locked in a nearly dead heat.
I was locked in a dead heat under the covers last night when Bricks started farting like a 4th of July fireworks finale.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Crushed. Second down and two.
Boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse. First down! He hit that line the way a rolled up dollar bill sticking out of flimsy Lohan's nose. It's a mayor in Lost Wages, Nevada.
And it's first and 10. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. Not much there, maybe a yard. Second down and 9. He had it for a second there. Third down and 9. Same page on that play. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And the punter has one job to do, and that's punt the ball. Preferably further than that.
It starts with a shank.
He's got the ball now and is going to... Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
The defender's one feet just kicked in.
He's so fast.
He is running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First first down. And it's first and 10. And he pounds the ball into the defense, picking up 7. Second and 3. Man, oh man, he hit that line the way your wife hits the all-you-can-eat buffet at Crab Apple Trees, Bricks.
You're telling me. She ate 47 Salisbury steaks one time. Thought she had food poisoning. Turns out her lower intestines just exploded.
No, that's a relief, because there's nothing worse than food poisoning.
You're telling me.
Oh, what a brutal hit. And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go. Boom! Third down and long. Hey kids, do you remember getting shoved in a locker because you wore glasses? I do. Join the MFL and try Roid Rage and have your revenge. And it's 1st and 10. Second down and a lot. The offense just burned the defense pretty hard on that one. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. I'd be impressed if he splits the uprights from this far away, Bricks.
If he doesn't, they're gonna split his skull wide open.
He's got the distance, and the kick is good! The teams have kept each other at bay for now, but there's still plenty of time to bribe refs and kill the other team's star players, so it's anyone's game, really, Bricks. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not gonna take it anymore. First down in a mile.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Second down in a very long.
Is the game over yet? I gotta go to the vet to have him reattach my big toe to where my thumb was again. It just fell off for the 3rd time today. I was barely even chewing on it.
Was a bone crusher right there, folks.
Okay,
Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy of 3 returns. Let's see if he beats the odds. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And it's 1st and 10. And he gets his bell rung for a yard. Second down and 9. The defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawning.
Third down and, well, good luck. He could go all the way. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he put all of his foot into that one. And he's got a chance for a good return here. And he breaks away.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
Wow, the quarterback just threw a sonic blast to his receiver, and he reels that one in for a 1st down to keep the drive alive. And it's 1st and 10. Looks like the defense called the ginormous dirty trick. A man hit, jars the ball loose, and it's a fumble. That's what happens when you hurdle and take a hard hit. Second down and 10. And he held on to that one for a 1st down. And it's 1st and 10. Second down and a lot. And the passing game picking up some steam, a gain of 7 there. Third down and 6. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. It's not short, but this one shouldn't give the kicker any trouble.
Unless he collapses under pressure and never makes another kick again.
That's bleak, Bricks. He is automatic. Nice kick.
Boring. Just getting the points and let's move on.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's 1st and 10.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grim.
2nd down and 9. 5-0-5. He picks up 8 yards on that pass. The QB saves some clock by calling a timeout. They have one left. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. And this guy's running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And they take their last time out.
It's between them and the clock now, Grim.
Well, and the defense, too. And it's 1st and 10. Get the first down and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. And then it's a 1st down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
Quarterback drills one in for the 1st down. 1st down and 3. Oh, the receiver has to make that catch. Now he put the team in a hole. A short but possibly essential field goal here.
Short but essential. That's what they call bricks.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just...
Snuffalo Thrills lose at their home stadium. And I'll tell you, the fans are not happy.
You think if I sang a little song, it might cheer them up?
Nobody thinks that. Nobody.
The opposition came into town and stole one from them. It's a bitter 1-point loss.
Just like a thief in the night. They should go to jail. Stealing ain't right, Grim.
Let's listen to what the game's most valuable player has to say about it.
Why? The guy's got the intelligence of a horseshoe.
Once again, the folks at EvilSN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off. Today.